So you went all over the world. You've been to Cannes, you've been to all these festivals.
Yes, Dedashka was in the Cannes short film corner. It also played in a world competition in the Iran Documentary Film Festival.
Iran. And you also went to school in Cuba and also in Africa?
Exactly, in Burkina Faso. Ouagadougou, Burkina Faso.
That's the name of a country or a school?
It's the name of the capital city. And the school is called Centre Imagine, the Imagine Centre. It's run by Gaston Cabaret, one of the premier African filmmakers. So yeah, that was an incredible experience. We did workshops with filmmakers and we went to the FESPACO, the Pan-African Film Festival. Fabulous experience. I crave to go back to Africa. Hopefully I'll make a documentary one day there.
Well, I'm sure you will, because not only that, this beautiful young lady is following the footsteps of our other star of last year, Oliver Irving, who was in the TIFF Talent Lab, and now you're on your way there.
Yeah, I'm heading off next week in a few days. I'm very, very excited to be attending TIFF.
You're gonna be meeting just about everybody who's there, I think.
Adam McGoyan, Don McKellar, Danny Boyle, who did Slumdog Millionaire, Tilda Swinton.
Tilda's gonna be there?
Yeah.
Uh-oh, Tilda's my BFF. Anyway.
Oh, okay. I'll tell her.
Hi,
that.
Tilda. Yo, she better find me. That's all I say. She better be on my show. Anyway, you were telling me yesterday about you had very interesting thoughts about the differences between English Canada and French Canada, and how there's such, and my viewers don't really know a whole lot about Quebec. I mean, if you've been watching carefully, you have a lot of information, but Montreal's the capital city of Quebec, and you were talking about the culture.
Well, no, it's in the capital city. Quebec City is the capital city.
Oh, that's right. Yes, yes.
But Montreal is the...
Thank you. Another mistake.
Montreal is the main city, yeah.
And you were talking about the sort of vibrancy and the ferocity of the French-Canadian culture. And
Quebec cinema has its own star system. It's a totally different culture from English Canada. English Canada don't have that same star system. In Quebec, if you can really make it in the Quebec system, and you can become, you know, it's like a mini Hollywood, like a French Hollywood in North America, which is very, very unique.
Yes, because it covers television and the stage as well as the films that we see.
And music and everything.
And people actors here really care about it.
Oh yeah, everyone's
very
passionate, very proud. It's a very intense culture. We love our stars.
Right, right. And your films are very beautiful, and your Concordia is... So you had 6 years of college, is that what I'm getting?
5 years.
Five, okay, no wonder they're so well educated. They go to school all more than we do.
So it's 3 years at Concordia in the Mel Hoppenheim School of Cinema, which is a fantastic program.
And that's a school, that's within the school, there's a Mel Oppenheim?
Yeah, Mel Hoppenheim School of Cinema.
And we were talking about Marie-José Croze, we just missed Kevin Klein, but you're here, we're here with Tamara Scherbak. Did I get that right, Scherbak?
Scherbak.
So you said you weren't really a real Québécois because you're not...
I'm not of French origin, but...
Right. So how did your parents come to be here? Is this sort of like an autobiographical thing about some family member?
Yes. This is a story about my grandfather.
Oh, it is?
His memories of World War II.
And the Holocaust.
He was taken from Ukraine to Germany with his entire family, and they were forced into forced labor camps to work. And actually, he tried to escape. Sadly, he failed. His escape attempt failed, and he got sent to a Gestapo jail. But luckily, he got pitied. He got pitied by the commander and got sent to a different forced labor camp because other people were shot or whatnot. And then eventually, they were freed by the French and taken to England, and then they immigrated to Canada after that.
Which is sort of what Dedashka is. That a
It means grandfather in Ukrainian.
Oh, that's so nice.
Really, I escaped. I tried to escape. Really, I didn't do it. I didn't escape. I mean, I was caught. They sent me to work in factory. I thought maybe there is a story, concentration camps, etc. You see, They could have sent me to concentration camp, no? We got up in the middle of the night and dressed up, and then we went. And we didn't know that that is actually about 7 and 8. There is many factories. There is many factories, and factories were open. So we run into people. So we had to go. We follow people. And then we come to a huge factory. We cannot think. Then we turn around, you see, and came different way. And again we come to factory.
And he was talking about his memories and how difficult it was to... This is sort of a video portrait is what this is, a short film portrait of your grandfather.
Well, it's interesting,
it was very
because,
moving.
While I was making this, initially I thought it would just be about his experiences, but he was developing dementia and Alzheimer's while I was shooting it, so it became about that as well.
I think I am too, but anyway, that's another program. No, go on, I'm sorry. Interrupting you with an Alzheimer's joke, but anyway.
That's good. I make those jokes all the time.
Okay.
So, so the film also became about memory. Yeah.
Yes.
Idea of
yes.
memory and how it changes and warps and crumbles over time and becomes something totally different. But it's something we need to hold on to because this generation of people are dying off. And all of their memories and experiences are going to disappear in 10, 20 years. And
well,
everybody need to document it.
That I grew up with, you know, the artists, my colleagues, you know, of mm-hmm. my people of my own age, most of them are gone from mm. AIDS. And I was fortunately a person who never drank or took drugs or mm-hmm. all of this. So I still have my, what's left of my memory left. So, you know, it's, I can remember all these things that there's nobody around. I should write a book, right?
Yeah.
Or
a documentary.
You should
do a documentary
about
on you.
Me.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Huh? We're starting it right here today on the Stephen Holt Show. We showed up wearing matching outfits completely serendipitously.
Exactly.
And,
great minds think alike.
Yes, I absolutely agree. And I love this poster this year, the festival. I think a student did
Molotov cocktail? I think so. I think they had a competition of some kind.
Right, and you were in the student... They have a... talk about the student...
Yes, they have a student film festival, which
right,
is...
That's right.
Yeah, open to CEGEP and university students from everywhere, I think. And yeah, they have great awards and prizes.
Did you win an award?
Sadly, I didn't. No,
but
not
you got
here.
To Cannes.
Yeah. I won awards at different festivals.
You've been to so many festivals. You've been to more festivals than I have, and you're only like 19 or something.
A little bit older than that.
A little bit older than that, but not much. Anyway,
not by
and
much,
so
no.
pretty. And you could be a film star yourself. Did you ever think about being an actress or something?
I have acted, yes. Since,
I knew it, yes.
Yes. Yeah. I might pursue it, yeah.
I don't want to take
so
off
my... If any casting directors are watching
right
this...
in the camera, and she's so beautiful. Très jolie. And maintenant, we're going to be joined, if you don't mind, by a very famous German director who just had, like, a standing ovation here and blew everybody away. He just flew in, and he's going to join us in a second. And we'll be right back. Ne bougez pas! Suivez-moi!